the anti-graft agency EFCC says former Justice Minister Mohammed Adoke is in its custody. Adoke returned to Nigeria on Thursday from Dubai, where he was arrested after about 4 years of self-imposed exile. On arrival in Abuja, he was arrested by officials of Interpol at the request of the EFCC. In a statement by its spokesperson, Wilson Wu-Jaren, the EFCC said Adoke, who fled the country in 2015, has pending criminal charges brought against him by the EFCC for alleged abuse of office and money laundering in respect of the granting of the oil prospecting license 245 to Shell and ENI. Adoke has denied any wrongdoing in the OPL 245 scandal, for which Shell, ENI and their top officials have been prosecuted in Italy. The controversial OPL 245 agreements, for which Shell and ENI paid about $1.1 billion, was mediated by Adoke while in office as Nigeria's Attorney General. Away from that story now, senior advocates of Nigeria Mike Ozekome and the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission have disagreed over the claims that nobody was allowed access to a former Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice Mohammed Adoke. This comes shortly after Adoke returned to Nigeria from Dubai in company with Interpol officers aboard Emirates Airlines Flight 785. Ozekome, who is Adoke's lawyer, alleged that neither he nor any other person was allowed to talk to the former AGF. According to the senior advocate, his client was picked up at the foot of the aircraft by Interpol officers and taken to the International Organization's office in Abuja. Reacting to the allegation, the anti-graft agency said that the claim of denying access to Adoke was not correct. Tony Amokode, who's the spokesman for the acting EFCC chairman Ibrahim Magu, confirmed that the former Attorney General of the Federation is already in the custody of the anti-graft agency.